Thank you very much, Ms. Sarah Wayne, distinguished speakers and also participants. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now entering the closing sessions of our high-level policy dialogue today. I would like to inform you that we have more than 300 people joining online, and so far we have more than 120 people also joining offline at Hotel Borobudur with us right now. And I would like to invite for Professor Iskandar Zulkarnain Siregar from IPB University to wrap up the sessions today. Please, Professor Iskandar, time is yours.
Okay, thank you. So I have a little slide, yeah, because my time is only 7 minutes according to the committee. So this is a wrap-up session. So I'm Iskandar Siregar from IPB University. Good afternoon. So we know that we have three sessions. Yeah? Session one is again to recall the palm oil price fluctuation and supply chains. Yeah? So in the morning, much longer discussion, very good discussion and full of new information, yeah, delivered by, I think, 7 resource person. The session two is a global food and energy crisis and impacts on the palm oil sustainability roadmap. So we're talking about the sustainability roadmap. The session three is environment, just now. Finish, environment and livelihoods of people facing the global crisis. Later, I think the committee will show on the slide the session one. The price fluctuation, of course, influenced by multi factors, yeah, such as global production decrease in mostly vegetable oils in many countries, many producing countries, disruption of supply due to conflicts or war, yeah, in this case. Next, this one. Third one, of course, climate change, weather anomaly. The fourth, policy changes in some market countries, yeah, considering the global situation. And the fifth is the use of course, this has been mentioned also, vegetable oil for biofuels. Impact of global palm oil price fluctuation and climate change, of course, rising in the price, but now, Indonesian, like in Indonesia, current cooking oil price is stabilizing. Decrease on yields, so we talk about the productivity, particularly more on smallholders. In this case, it's independent. The third one, develop. So there are a lot of discussion on developing mitigation and adaptation strategies via certification instrument or sustainability standards. Links between the price fluctuation and supply chains, as well as the governance, global CPO trade is in Indonesia for not regulated for food and fuels, including at the site level. Identified gaps in the sustainability system. So in this case, we need more capacity building. Identified vulnerable smallholders versus the non-ones, and consideration also on the palm oil labors. So labors, very important, especially when we discuss with the industry or companies, yeah, facing maybe shortage of labors in the future. The measures discussed addressing the expected, the next, I would say, booming in the production due to yield improvement because of a lot of initiative for improving the productivity. And it was not also the working at the sub-national level, like district level, for securing the, let's say, good prices, despite in the future or in the next coming months or years, oversupply. And the third one, discussing on the benefit sharing mechanism for certification, such as the how to handle the audit costs, especially for the smallholders. Next. The second one, global food energy crisis and impacts on the oil palm sustainability roadmap. Yeah, So Professor Harry mentioned about the four identified key drivers for the crisis, conflict, harvest failure or losses, yeah, poverty and inequality. However, the crisis, despite the crisis or disruption, there are still positive trends, increase in the product certification and also the commitment, yeah, towards the sustainability. This is very important. Current global supply chain is fragile, and the subsequent impact due to this condition hits harder on the disadvantaged groups, yeah, the ones who have very small size area with low productivity and lack of capacity. The measures, more and more collaboration, it is easy to be mentioned, but we need, yeah, producers, buyers, country, let's talk together. Keep meeting the sustainability criteria, including sticking to the standard of sustainability. More dialogues on trade and markets, transparency and traceability, including research and innovation. We should appreciate the result of the research innovation. Continuing the works for the global recognition of the national standard, like ISPO Budia has mentioned. Sharing the cost for reaching the sustainable palm oil, eliminating the bad actors, yeah, extending the certified markets to alternative ones, the country like in Asia, yeah, India, China, and accelerating the ISPO for smallholders. Next, the third one, environment and livelihood. We still we just heard from the resource person, more discussion. Now, okay, with beyond the climate issue and desperation, in this case is food system, for example, has been mentioned by Pak Surya, yeah, through the different kind of innovation. More attention on intercropping, although it is at small scale trials, but we need to recheck, yeah, the potential of this kind for food, securing the food security, biodiversity enrichment in the plantation, etc. Smallholders' livelihood is very vulnerable. Impact on the crisis on the livelihood, we heard from the field, for example, water resources, and it also have a consequences on the household consumption. Pests, in this case, an example is sama ulat api, and number of, because of this situation, increasing the number of poor household. The measure increasing resilience, doing more capacity building on good agriculture practice. Last one is maybe from the last discussion, reconciling the policies and the actors. For example, using the landscapes approach. Next, I think that's all I could do, yeah, but of course this can be enriched, yeah, with more discussion and a better organization. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Professor Iskandar, for the wrap-up of the talk sessions. Now, please welcome Mrs. Brigitta Iswara from C4 ICRAF and also a senior journalist who will lead the way forward roundtable discussion planning. Ms. Brigitta, please, the time is yours.
Terima kasih Mbak Diah. Selamat sore semua peserta diskusi panel, baik yang hadir di sini secara offline maupun yang online. Saya akan menggunakan bahasa Indonesia untuk menyampaikan way forward. Oke, hari ini kita telah mendengar banyak sekali insight. Insightnya demikian kaya dari semua panelis dan juga tadi dihantarkan oleh Prof. Harry adalah hasil penelitian yang menunjukkan kompleksitas persoalan terkait perdagangan palm oil serta kaitannya dengan krisis pangan, energi, dan krisis ekonomi global yang sekarang kita hadapi. Oke, dalam isu perdagangan global palm oil, kita telah mendengar kaitan-kaitan yang demikian kompleks, yang cukup rumit antara penetapan harga di pasar global dengan persoalan sustainability yang kita idam-idamkan. Dan juga menyangkut kesejahteraan petani non-plasma atau non-mitra. Dari hasil penelitian ditemukan bahwa faktor penting untuk tercapainya sustainability yang muncul adalah persoalan tenaga kerja dan kondisi no deforestation, dan di atas semua itu adalah green buyers. Semua aktor, baik itu pengusaha besar, korporasi, maupun pengusaha petani besar dan juga petani non-plasma, memiliki tantangannya sendiri, namun yang paling rentan adalah dan terkena dampak terberat dari semua krisis dan situasi perdagangan global palm oil adalah para petani non-plasma. Nah, kita tahu dari apa yang kita diskusikan bahwa tantangan ke depan ini akan semakin berat, tidak akan berakhir dalam waktu dekat. Karena apa? Karena perubahan iklim sekarang sudah berubah menjadi krisis iklim, dan kasus pandemi kita tidak tahu apakah sudah berakhir betul-betul, terutama karena perang Ukraina-Rusia yang tidak pernah kita bayangkan akan terjadi di era ini. Berangkat dari apa yang telah kita diskusikan hari ini, maka kita harus terus berjalan, tidak bisa berhenti di sini, untuk mencari strategi yang tepat. Jika kita belum bisa mendapatkan solusi, at least kita bisa mendapatkan strategi yang tepat, karena kondisi akan selalu berubah dalam perjalanan ke depan. Nah, untuk itu C4 Ikrah berencana melakukan roundtable discussion untuk mendiskusikan persoalan ini lebih dalam lagi dan lebih terbuka lagi dalam diskusi yang bisa diharapkan akan dilakukan secara periodik. Dan diskusi itu diharapkan lebih intens, mendalam, dan melibatkan berbagai stakeholder yang lebih luas lagi. Untuk itu, sebelum kita bisa membuat roundtable discussion, kami meminta Anda semua yang online maupun offline untuk turut memberikan usulan topik apa saja sih yang harus diberi perhatian lebih dalam lagi, yang harus kita diskusikan, harus kita analisa lebih dalam lagi, kita perdebatkan di masa mendatang. Nah, untuk itu kita menggunakan aplikasi untuk mendapatkan Word Cloud. Ya, Anda semua bisa memasukkan usulan melalui link tersebut. Jadi ini di scan ya QR-nya ya, Mbak Diah. QR-nya di scan. Atau sudah ada di meja masing-masing. Silakan. Di AHA. Ya, ya, tolong di-download, masuk ke dalam gadget, kemudian di situ akan ada 3 poin, usulan apa, topik apa saja yang Anda ingin lebih didiskusikan secara mendalam. Diharapkan 3 topik dari setiap peserta. Nanti kami akan melihat hasil dari masukan yang diberikan melalui Word Cloud. Word Cloud itu akan menunjukkan kata-kata apa yang paling sering muncul. Itu artinya bahwa jumlah terbesar yang muncul adalah kata-kata itu. Kondisi perdagangan palm oil, terutama untuk kepentingan negara dan juga terutama para petani yang tadi banyak dikatakan rentan terhadap menderita dampak dari semua persoalan perdagangan global dan krisis. Wow. Oke. Okay. Ini menarik sekali ya. Silakan ketik ya, 50 orang, 49 live participants, 49 live participants, 47, 46, 45, oh banyak juga. Ini nggak salah ya, ada satu kata yang nggak bergerak-gerak, Mbak Diah. Nggak salah ya. Dan tadi tidak ada kata itu sebenarnya. Rupanya kata itu ditunggu-tunggu dari tadi nggak keluar. Oke, rupanya. Ya, apakah sudah semua? Right. Wow, unexpected. Kenapa yang lain hurufnya sama besar ya? Ini membingungkan. Oke. Oh, baik, udah selesaikah ini Mbak Diah? Could we assume that this is already done?
Yes, I think we can assume that it's already done.
Okay. Oh, no. Still moving. Oh, nice. 256. Menarik sekali. Lumayan ya, ini berarti pesertanya banyak dan semua berkontribusi. Ini sungguh melegakan. Setelah ini mungkin bisa dibikin kaos ya. Sudah?
I think you can assume that it's done because as long as people are putting their feedback, it will keep moving around.
Oh, I see. Yeah. So you should stop the feedback?
Well, sort of. Yes.
Yes. So please do what you should do.
I think for the participants, you can stop to send feedback now so that we can have a final wrap up.
Yeah. I ask for the all participants, please stop the feedback so we can just see what the result is. Well, the result is the most is gender, the word gender, and the second one is Papua, and the third one is metapopulasi. Okay, and close to that is NKT oligarchy biodiversity. Which one? High conservation value. Yeah, but the three that the most choose is metapopulasi, Papua, gender, and then high conservation value. We can take note on that. Yeah, is anybody take note of this? Yeah, I think someone from C4. Yeah, okay, I'll write it down. Okay. gender, metapopulasi, oligarki, biodiversity. Mbak Dia, can we save it? Yeah, okay, good. Baik, dengan demikian kita sudah menyaksikan semua word cloud-nya adalah seperti ini. Maka nanti secara internal oleh C4 akan digagas bagaimana untuk menyelenggarakan roundtable discussion-nya. Siap-siap aja mungkin di antara Anda semua yang hadir di sini akan mendapatkan undangan untuk terlibat dan dalam roundtable discussion. Dengan ini maka tugas saya sudah selesai. Terima kasih atas semua partisipasinya pada akhir dari rangkaian acara panel diskusi ini. Salam sehat untuk kita semua. Semoga kita bisa bertemu lain kali dalam kondisi yang lebih baik. Terima kasih, selamat sore.
Thank you very much, Ms. Brigitta, for the leading the way forward roundtable discussion planning. And also thank you, your distinguished guests and also participant for your participations. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to inform you that the presentations from this high-level policy dialogue can be accessed in the event webpage and also will be emailed to you along with certificate. Committee, can you show the link for the presentation material? This is the event webpage that you can access. And ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of our high-level policy dialogue today, palm oil and environmental sustainability, facing food, climate, and also energy crisis. Thank you very much for your participation. We hope to see you again on the next Trade Hub event, and see you. And please give a round of applause for all of us.